The 1995 Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, with its gender-responsive provisions, has guided the national agenda on women's human rights. As we celebrate 25 years since the promulgation of the 1995 Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, we look back and reflect on the milestones achieved towards championing women's rights. Uganda's Vision 2040 is a transformed society, from peasant to a modern prosperous country, where all Ugandans aspire for a future in which men and women are accorded equal opportunities to participate as equal partners in development, providing women and girls with quality education, healthcare, decent work, access and ownership, rights over property and technology, and equal participation in political and economic decision-making processes will lead to social, economic and environmental sustainability across the country. The Constitution provides overall legal framework for gender equality and equity. It recognizes equality between women and men and outlaws any form of discrimination. The government of Uganda has enacted several laws to promote women's human rights. Some of these include the National Women's Council Act 1993, the Domestic Violence Act 2010, the Prohibition of Female Genital Mutilation Act 2010, and the Prevention of Trafficking in Persons Act 2009, the Persons with Disabilities Act as amended 2019, the Child Amendment Act 2016, among others. Achieving gender equality in education requires that girls and boys, women and men, access and complete education cycles and are empowered through education. Uganda has achieved gender balance on pre-primary enrollment at 49.5% for boys and 50.5% for girls. The primary education enrollment has increased from 49.9% for girls and 50.1% for boys in 2008 to 50% for both girls and boys in 2015, and completion from 47% for girls and 51% for boys in 2008 to 72% for both girls and boys in 2015. Secondary education net enrollment rate stands at 81.1%, 83.5% for girls, and 82.3% for boys. Uganda Certificate of Education UCE Performance Index at 42.2%, girls at 39.7% compared to boys at 44.5%, while the Performance Index at the Uganda Advanced Certificate of Education 62% for girls compared to 59% for boys. The literacy rate of females and males has improved from 51% and 70% in 1997 to 69.9% and 77.5% in 2016, respectively. Infant mortality rate has reduced from 81 in 2000 to 54 in 2015. Maternal mortality rate has reduced from 505 in 2000 to 336 in 2019. Total fertility rate has drastically reduced from 6.9 in 2000 to 5.4 in 2019. Deliveries in health facilities increased from 37% in 2000 to 73% in 2015, and the use of contraceptive methods by married women doubled over the period 1995 to 2011 from 15% to 35%. Teenage pregnancy and motherhood is exceptionally high at 25%, and this has far-reaching implications to the lives of child mothers and that of their children. Government has invested in health infrastructure to improve access and provide affordable quality health care for the population, including women and girls, at different levels of service delivery. The percentage of health center fours conducting cesarean section improved from 24% in 2000 to 45% in 2015. A recent investment in the newly constructed 450-bed specialized women and neonatal wing at Mulago National Referral Hospital. Ownership of property among women is still a challenge. Only 38% of women own a house, compared to 54% of men, while 31% of women own land, compared to 48% of men who own land, which is significant improvement from 16% of women who owned land in 2000. According to Finscope Uganda 2009 and 2018, formal financial access for adults has significantly improved from 28% in 2009 to 78% in 2018, with minimal difference between women and men. through different initiatives, government aims at sustaining and promoting the rights of women to ensure that they are economically and financially viable. These include Uganda Women Entrepreneurship Program, UWEP, which began in financial year 2015-2016. By October 2019, a total of 10,446 women projects had been financed, directly benefiting 130,258 women, including those in rural areas who comprise 80% of beneficiaries. Together with UN partners, government established the Green Jobs Program, which targets all women and youth in the promotion of sustainable work. Under this project, women are empowered with tools to engage in Jua Kali enterprises, such as the manufacturing of eco stoves, recycling and garbage collection, as well as tailoring, among others. The ICT sector has grown fast, which has allowed women to use ICT products to boost communication and access to information, which in turn opens up economic opportunities. Ownership of cell phones has improved from 13% among women and 29% among men in 2006-2007 to 45.8% among women and 58.2% among men in 2012 and 2013. Almost as many women as men owned a radio individually, 43% and 42% respectively. Currently, there are 33 senior ministers, 12 of whom are women, 36% compared to the 21% in 2004. Out of 46 ministers of state, 14 are women, 30.43%. Within the opposition shadow cabinet, 8 out of 39 shadow ministers, 20.5%, are women. The 10th parliament has 157 female members of parliament, 116 of whom are district women MPs. The percentage of female representatives in parliament now stands at 34.86%. The 10th parliament featured two female leaders of the opposition for the first time, and the speaker for the 9th and 10th parliaments has been female. Increasingly, women are leading parliamentary committees, with 11 committees out of 28 being chaired by women. Additionally, women make up 46% of chairs of the standing committees and 41% of the standing committee vice chairs. In 2016, women constituted 45.7% of all local government representatives, 27,755 persons. Within the judiciary, women constitute 44% of judges in the higher levels of the High Court, 36% in the Court of Appeal, and 44% in the Supreme Court. The Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, in implementing the National Policy and Action Plan on the Elimination of Gender-Based Violence in Uganda 2016, the National Strategy on Ending Child Marriage and Teenage Pregnancy 2016 to 2020, the Referral Pathway for Response to Gender-Based Violence Cases in Uganda 2013, and the Guidelines for Establishment and Management of GBV Shelters in Uganda 2013. This regulatory framework has empowered state, non-state, and individual actors with effective tools to combat all forms of GBV, leading to a more holistic and integrated response to FGM. The ministry has also engaged cultural institutions in the drafting of declarations and local governments in drafting council resolutions that address different forms of GBV, paying special attention to child marriages, FGM, and HIV and AIDS. Whereas more women than men experienced physical violence in Uganda, it is important to note that the prevalence has reduced from 59.9% in 2006 to 51% in 2016. In conclusion, Uganda has made significant progress in promoting gender equality and women's empowerment attributed to the 1995 Constitution. The existing gender gaps also present great opportunities for the government of Uganda to accelerate gender equality and women's empowerment for sustainable national development.